There are various organizations that rank democracy in the world, typically measuring how well a country stacks up against five core measures: freedom of expression, freedom of association and assembly, judicial independence, effective parliament, and media integrity. By these measures, America is backsliding, largely because of the after effects of Donald Trump's undermining and denial of the outcome of the 2020 election. But democratic backsliding is the norm today, even within NATO countries. Hungary, Slovenia, even where I am, Poland, are all backsliding. The number of countries moving in an authoritarian direction in 2020 outnumbered those going in a democratic direction. That's according to a report by the International Institute for Democracy and Electoral Assistance. The report also found that more than a quarter of the world's population is now living in democratically backward countries that, together with those living in outright non-democratic regimes, make up more than two-thirds of the total global population. So, in Poland yesterday, Joe Biden, while speaking about Vladimir Putin, said, "The guy's gotta go." And for a moment, my heart leapt. The leader of the free world was finally saying what had to be said about an imperialistic despot. Now, let's be clear. America does not do this well, this idea of getting involved to save civilian populations. We did it totally the wrong way in Afghanistan. Despite our red lines, Syria remains a failed state, propped up by Iran and Russia, with most of the population in exile. The Rohingya in Myanmar continue to be persecuted by the majority. The government of India continues to crack down on the freedoms of the Muslims in Kashmir. The Uyghur Muslims of Western China are forced into so-called re-education, hard labor concentration camps, where forced cultural assimilation and even sexual assault are reported to prevail. The citizens of Hong Kong lose more of their Western-style freedoms daily, and the people of Taiwan are watching their skies for the Chinese jets they soon expect to unleash hell on them. There is still no meaningful democracy in the Middle East. That includes Israel, by the way, which exercises control over Palestinians in the West Bank. In the Americas, Brazil, Venezuela, Peru, Nicaragua, Honduras, and Mexico are all backsliding democratically. In Africa, Niger, Benin, Mauritania, Cameroon, and Zimbabwe are backsliding. Mali and Cote d'Ivoire have ceased to be democracies entirely. And here in Europe, Hungary, Serbia, Poland, Turkey, all going in the wrong direction. And so we have Ukraine, the world's most obvious chance to take a stand for democracy and against colonialism, imperialism, and war. Ukraine has a new president brought in on a wave of anti-corruption. Unlike the Afghans, who had been beaten down by warlords, fanatics, and corruption, or Syrians, who had a series of only bad choices to make between a politically repressive government and a morally repressive gang of religious perverts, Ukrainians have the rare confluence of global attention and existing good and true government. They have complete freedom of expression and association and assembly. They have worked hard to erase corruption and achieve judicial independence. They have an effective gender balance and unusually young parliament. They have a working and effective media, or at least they did until Russia attacked. Ukraine can stand up to the imperial expansionist Russia with the world's help, with America's help. On Saturday, Joe Biden stepped into the breach when he said, "He's gotta go." Russian officials freaked out about it, saying Putin's fate was for the Russian people to decide, which is laughable because the Russian people don't have the freedom of association or assembly or judicial independence or a functioning electoral system. The Russian people can't decide anything about their politics unless they launch a revolution. What surprised me more is that the White House freaked out about it too, walking it back a little. I heard Joe Biden say it, and I was proud of America when he did. America cannot fix the world's problems, but it sure can help by leading the world in the right direction. Joe Biden sees naked Russian expansionist ambitions for exactly what they are, and he wants them stopped. He knows if Ukraine falls, so falls the democratic world's best hope of fighting back the global tide of authoritarianism and dictatorship. What's next? Moldova, which like Ukraine doesn't have NATO protections, or Poland or Lithuania, both of which do? This war in Ukraine is unprovoked and illegal. Ukrainians have held the line longer than anyone expected them to. Their leaders have rallied the world and their people. They're calling themselves the front line of democracy in the world, and I think they might be correct. What America can do is hold those high who are trying to make their societies more equitable, more just, and more democratic, and to push back against those who don't. And when the breaches are of a magnitude that NATO and the EU and the G7 and the G20 struggle with what to do, the American president can speak for the entire democratic world. That's what Joe Biden did yesterday when he said of Putin, the guy's got to go. The White House says it was an unscripted moment with Joe Biden. All the best ones are with him. I think he said what he meant, and if he did mean to say it, he was right and should stick to it. Democracy isn't this halfway thing. Ukraine has it. Russia's trying to invade it and crush it, like Russia has done so many times before in so many places. It's time for this to stop, and it's time for this type of thing to stop all around the world. And it's time for the U.S. to make making it stop its business. Joe Biden is in the right place on this one.